Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1526, Excel on the iPad. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin from Mr. Excel. I was out at the MVP Summit a couple weeks ago, and one of the things I learned was just an offhand comment that is incredible. All right, so here we have Excel on the laptop. Here we have an iPad. Find that I'm doing a lot of the iPad. I browse on the iPad. I do my Gmail on the iPad. I use the iPad for everything, but I don't like numbers on the iPad. They can't create new Excel files. They can create old Excel files. It's clunky. I just don't like numbers. I'm sorry. I want Excel on the iPad. Today, I'm going to give you Excel on the iPad. Here's what we do. You start with your spreadsheet here in Excel 2010. If you're in Excel 2007, you're going to have to go direct to the SkyDrive. From Excel 2010, we do File, Save and Send, Save to the Web, and then you're going to sign in with your SkyDrive account. Now, if you don't have a SkyDrive account, go to skydrive.live.com and sign up. It's free. Create some folders. Right, I have a folder here called Public, and I've shared that with everyone, so you can go try this out yourself. And we'll do Save As to save the file in that folder. All right. Now, we're going to close it here in Excel. By the way, the SkyDrive does show up then in your recent places, all right? So you can get right back to it. It's just like practically like a hard drive. All right, now. Okay, so now here is the really, really non-intuitive part. You're on the iPad, you go to skydrive.live.com, and you're gonna be able to see those files that you uploaded. The piece that no one knows, and I learned this from an Excel PM named Harrison, you have to scroll down to the bottom of the browser window, and there is a link there called PC Site, right? That link is the magic link. Right now, you're looking at the mobile version of SkyDrive, and the mobile version will not let you edit the Excel files. Click PC Site, then all of a sudden, you're on the real version of SkyDrive, and now the editing works, all right? This setting is not persistent. Almost every day, you're gonna have to go back in and choose PC Site. There's a hack to get it to be persistent, but then all of your websites would not give you the mobile site, and that's going to be more hassle than it's worth. All right, so let's switch over and take a look at the iPad now. Okay, so now here we are on the iPad. This is the SkyDrive. I'm in the public folder, and you know, at this point we can still use the stretch to make it larger. I'm going to click on Machine Reading, which is the file that I saved from the desktop. Oh, this is perfect. This is beautiful. Okay, now this is exactly what happens if you don't click PC Site. All right, so here we are. We see the results. The chart's not showing up. And there's no way to edit and browse. You see, there's no edit and browse there. So I'm going to go back. Okay, so here we are. Back at the main drive. I'm going to focus in down here at the bottom. See that link right there? PC Site. That's the important one. Choose PC Site, and now we have a completely different experience. Look, you have the file menu up there, open in Excel, edit in browser, and the chart is rendering. So let's give it a try. Edit in browser. Choose a cell, so I'll click here in cell A11. All right, now to actually enter anything in that cell, to get the keyboard, click in the formula bar. The keyboard appears. Let's enter a time of 9:45. Return. Click in the formula bar. Use the keyboard, 117.1. Return. All right, and our chart updates. Now here's the wild, wild thing. When you're using this mobile version of Excel, Excel for the web, the limitation of having one person edit the spreadsheet at a time has gone away. All right, so I'm gonna take a look at the PC here. So on the PC screen, you can see a browser. This is Internet Explorer here, showing the exact same spreadsheet in edit mode that we are seeing on the iPad. All right, now I'm gonna put the webcam on the iPad, and you can see on the regular screen, I'm going to enter 9:55. I'll use the right arrow key, and there it just appeared on the iPad. Did you see that? That's crazy. Anyone can be editing. You edit on either side, and it shows up in the other place. Absolutely wild. There's about a 3 or 4 second lag there as it gets saved up to the SkyDrive, and then the other device sees it. So hey, I think this is pretty darn cool. I want to say thanks to Harrison out at Microsoft for showing me that PC site. Again, that PC site link at the bottom, that's the amazing link that enables all of this to work. Using Excel on the SkyDrive, now edit your spreadsheets in on the iPad. Very, very cool. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.